Hello everyone, and welcome back to another brick in the mall. Yes, I said it properly this time. I didn't say wall, I said mall this time. Don't make fun of me. So today we're going to be working on where we left off, which was, I believe, our current event was back to school season for the next 16 hours. Autumn starts up afterwards. We've got a major game release, and Halloween is back again. So we gotta stock our shelves with candies and greeting cards. Our grocery store is looking good. It's not too packed. We've got workers that are just sitting around on their phones. Sue, you're 64 years old. I'm pretty sure you don't know how to operate your device. Yeah, look at you. Get off your phone. Go work or something. What about you? Mel Marks. They're just standing there. I'm literally paying them like $12 an hour to just stand around. Go do something. There we go. Yes. Go stock up. Our lines are nice and empty, unfortunately. Garbage is nice and clean. Parking lot's filling up. We're going to add another bus stop. Oh, actually, underground parking is $200,000? $200,000. I didn't realize that I was researching for underground parking and it's gonna cost me $200,000. Ah, I'm poor. I don't have that kind of money. So we're gonna put another bus stop. Let's put it right at the end here. And we're gonna put a bus stop here. And we'll put one more right there. So we can get that out the way. We've got to research. We can go with a coffee shop. Would be nice. Or perhaps we can go towards our alcohol license. I think we're gonna go with the alcohol license. It shouldn't take too long. Probably a week or so. I've put them down to, I want to say, 2 hours a day. Let's see here. Office. Staff. Yeah, they're working only 2 hours a day. And I believe that comes up to 160. Yeah, $160. So daily I'm paying them $160 for my 8 office workers. We got some cleaning up to do. There we go. We cleaned it up. Nice. Line's looking full again. What are they purchasing? Here, select. Russell Spence. He's queuing for bottled water. Okay. Someone purchased some meat. Bottled water. Some more bottled... Oh, fresh bread. They're also... They bought some cosmetics. And then they came back in line and bought some fresh bread. Look at this person's face right here. This lady right here. Look at this dude. Could you even see? I gotta change that up. How old are you? 36 years old. Dominic Zamora. Drugstore is looking empty. No one wants their drugs. That's sad. Let's see what's on demand when it comes to the drugs. Cosmetics, tampons, tooth care, soap and shampoo, diapers, deodorants. Okay. I believe I got deodorants, diapers, more deodorant. I've got first aid. Cosmetics. Some drugs, first aid. I got some tooth care, soap and shampoo. Nice, I got that on here. And some more drugs. We're in the green, so that's good. Net profit daily, we hit at least quite a bit over $3,000 to $4,000. As a gross profit daily, we make out almost $10,000. And then we're paying basically $5,000 in salary. So that's where all of our money's going towards. Almost $5,000 worth for salary. That's crazy. Some people either have to get some shorter shifts, or they need to get fired or something, because that's a lot of money. Restaurant's looking good. I've never seen all four seats or all eight seats packed. Objective complete. Have 100 customers on site. Very nice. Very nice. Oh, look at these lines. This is business right here. Back to school sales right here. Oh man, look at that money. But then tomorrow is going to be a totally different story. We're not going to be this jam-packed. We've got some grievances. 49 occurrences. Customers are leaving without buying anything. And our next objective is to complete, I believe it said, 200 customers on site, and we get 200,000, or 20,000, sorry. There we go. So now for our midnight, we only have one person. From midnight to about 4 or 5, we only have one cashier. I've noticed that having 2 or 3, there's not that many customers. So if within the next day or two, that's the same thing, and we've got, we can use both cashiers or three cashiers, and I'll switch back. But for now, we'll just go with the two. Customers are leaving the center because they are hungry, and there are no restaurants or restaurants are full. When was that? We're going to add another, let's add some more tables. And they're considering this to be a fast food restaurant. Was I able to make anything else other than the fast food? There's the fast food warmer, diner table, fast food cooking range, coffee table. No, that's it. Yeah, that's it. So we're gonna add some restaurant tables. You know what? Yeah, no. I think I mentioned this in the previous video. I'm gonna leave this location the way that it is. Ooh, not right in front of the bathroom. That's kinda gross. Let's put you here, and we can put a table here. So they should be able to walk between these blocks or just walk around. Like I was saying, we're gonna end up putting a food court somewhere up here. Would be the next little project for me to do. Or expand on the restaurant that we already have, but it's kind of already taking up a bunch of space, so I don't think I'm gonna do that. And we have $85,000 to play with. So let's see. We're close to making our daily profit over $5,000, and we'll collect $20,000 reward for that. We have to sell 40 different types of products. On that note, I'm going to expand our grocery store. I'm going to add a door. We're going to add our door. Where is it? Double door. We'll add that like so. We can also, let's see, I've got ice cream unlocked. The frozen vegetables and all those other products are locked. What else? The board games are unlocked. What about food? Got quite a bit of stuff that's still locked. What about the clothes rack? Okay, so the clothes rack isn't opened up. So we can make a specific clothes store. I'm also waiting to see if they can send me another hint to let me know what people would like. Or I guess I can go into the demand. So demand all. School supplies, yeah, school supply was high up there. T-shirts was up there. Liquor is up there. Games are up there. Fitness is up there as well, but school supplies was up there only because of the sales that were going on. Video games would be the next one. Okay, so let's see how the research is going. They're at 50% for the alcohol license. So I think I'm going to speed that up a little bit more. They're doing a really good job. I'm proud of the team that I got here so far for the grocery store. They can do with an upgrade. So let's change up the tiles. Let's give them... let's give them these stone tiles. Let's go with this stone tile right here. How much is that gonna cost? Just for the customers. We'll give that to the customers. Oops. Go. So they can feel a little bit special. We've got the red line for... I'm gonna make this whole floor red. So the moment they walk in, they can just be hungry. Just be extra hungry. So go here. Red tile here. Red tiles right there. At the back. They can have some nice looking tiles. Nice. Very nice. I like very much. We're already at 600 sales for the day. That's crazy. We're doing really good. Alright, so we've expanded our grocery store. Not by a lot, but enough to get us the objective completed. So we're gonna have to build. Where is it? We've got the shelves. No, not the shelves. We're gonna want the fridge, I believe. Let's see. Let me click on a fridge. And then we can tell from here. So we're not selling any sodas. We're not selling any juice. Oh, the lines are full. Ooh. We're getting close to 12 o'clock. I hope they can handle it. We're gonna have to pause on the... let's see. Getting closer to 12 o'clock is when we don't have big lines for our 24-hour... restaurant still. Nope, the restaurant's closed. How's the line going? The line's going good, but I might have to call back our second cashier to come in for midnight to 6 o'clock shift. Okay. So we don't have any juice or pop. So we're gonna add them right there and two right here. Next, we don't have any. Let's go back to our food shelves. Food wise, we're not selling any candy, snacks, cookies, or coffee. So we can build four food shelves. Oh, just four. Two. Okay, so we got four. And the fruits and vegetables. I'm pretty sure I have everything up there. Two fruits, two vegetables, two fresh breads. So we should be okay on that. We're going to be unlocking... is there a line full again? No, we're good. We're going to be expanding on the liquor and the beer. So we're going to need three more food shelves for that. Could I put them in a fridge? Beer can go in the fridge, and that's it. For the shelves, food shelves, we're gonna need the food shelves to put up the liquor, the beer, and the wine. So we'll put that in the back here. We can put all the liquor and the alcohol at the top here. So for these, we're gonna put... This object does not belong to any active zone. Yes, that's right. Let's assign the store. There we go. Yeah. All right, select. So we want soda, juice. Another juice. We've got the candies, snacks, because you know it's all about them snacks, cookies, hopefully Oreos. I've been having a craving for Oreos for the past like month now. It's crazy. All right, office, how are you guys going? Having a good day? Yeah, is everyone happy? Oh, everyone's very happy. You're getting 4 hours a day. You're lucky. What else do we have? Lines kind of died down. Oh no, it's 8 o'clock in the morning, so we're just getting the day started. Food-wise, we're going really good. We've got our recycling. Everything's looking nice. We've got a lot of storage. And we are at 96%. Here, let's see if I can skip this. Yep, there it is. The alcohol license has been achieved. So now we have our license to serve alcohol. I'm going to unlock the bars. And then after that, we are going to, unfortunately, get rid of our workers once again for about, I would say, maybe another week, and then have them come back in when our profits go back up from the sales, from the food that we have serving at our restaurant, and when we open up our new bar. Because I will be opening up a bar, and I'm gonna see if I can perhaps put it somewhere behind, awkwardly behind the drugstore, because drugs and alcohol should not be mixed together, and we're gonna have a drugstore close to a bar. That's the plan. That's what I'm going with. Lines are nice and full. Love it, love it, love it. Alcohol. We got liquor. We've got beer. We've got wine. And last but not least, if we can check our demands, beer is all the way up. Liquor is all the way up. So let's go with beer. Okay, looking good. It's still considered a grocery store? Good. Restaurant. Everyone's happy. Are you happy? You're eating, so I'm guessing. Oh, she's a glutton. June Rasmussen is a glutton. Who else is here? She's constipated. Rochelle Olson. Oh, she left. Well, she was constipated. We've got our cook that's just chilling. Who else do we have? We've got Philip McKee. He's a vapor. And he has a strong stomach. Is that good or bad? I'm not sure if that's supposed to be good or bad. Nice. Why are they getting upset? Why are you getting upset? Oh, we got slow cat. No. How fast is our cashier? Oh, she's out of yellow. That's not too bad. What about him? His cashier speed is super high. We shouldn't have any problems. We got 62 people that are leaving. Whoa. Okay. So if that's the case, we are going to have to open up another cashier with little to no space left. We're gonna have to move our we're gonna have to move our drugstore up a notch. Let's go up to there. Cut it. Ooh, that's gonna be right in front of the door. Let's not do that. Put you here. Let's switch you to there. And switch you to here. Alright, cashiers now. Oh my goodness. I'm so sorry. Queue size 10. Okay. So now we're going to have to add a cashier here. Hopefully that alleviates the work on our other cashiers. So you can go there. I should honestly add another one, but for now we'll add one more. Just the one for now. Oh, it's not considered the drugstore anymore because I moved it. Oh, it's considered a beauty shop. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. 5, so we have to hire, I believe we're gonna say 2 more workers. 2 or 3. No, 2. We're gonna go from 6 to 2 and from 2 to 9. We're getting a lot more customers in the morning. Oh, it's 2 o'clock, 3. We've had 40 people? Whoa. Is it all for, I'm gonna slow this down. Is it all for the grocery store? We had 67 people. There's no way. I looked at that lineup. We were perfectly fine. Alright, we're gonna have to add another person to that night shift. So we're gonna have 3 people working that night shift. If that doesn't fix the situation that we have when it comes to having customers leave the store, that I might have to have a complete brand new set of 4 people working the night shift. Either that or I'm just being greedy and I should cut down on the hours. So instead of it being a 24-hour operation, have it just be, I don't know, 12 hours or something. But we cut out and we lose money that way. I don't see anyone complaining now. We are. Look at that. 30 people. Could I slow it down? Slow down. It's like they're getting close to the end, to the beginning of the line, and then they're leaving. See, like, he almost got pissed off. This dude right here looks like, nope, did they leave? It says 56, 57. I don't see anyone getting pissed off. Oh, right there. There's one person. This person was already pissed off, though. How does that count? That's so weird. The line starts back here, not over here. He was pissed off from back here and then left. Everyone is getting pissed off. Look at it. You're just waiting to buy sliced bread. Oh, this cashier sucks. They should have a button for, like, training so I can, like, train him or something. I'd love for that to be a thing where, like, you can train them, pay for them to get trained. Because now we have 5 people working. 5 people are working. with 10 people that can be in the line at a time, meaning that we have almost 50 people in our lines, and we've missed out on almost 70 customers. That's a lot of money. And we're still spending almost $5,000 on salary. We're making a profit of $10,000, but then $5,000 of it is gone. $900 of it is gone towards maintenance. What else? Just like, look, we're almost at 100 customers that left, apparently. But I'm not seeing it. I'm not seeing any of the customers walk away. Unless the mechanic is... The mechanic looks like they get all red, and then they leave. Maybe there's a mechanic where if they walked up to the line and the line's full, then they leave as well? So I think that's a thing, because we just lost 100 customers. Meaning I have to open up another cashier. That's crazy. I literally have to open up another cashier. Again. Which I might be infringing on. Yeah, look it. I'm infringing on store 7. So we're gonna have to cut this. So we're gonna go store. No, we can go from, yeah, store 3 and cut it right to there. So now that's store 7, and this belongs to store 3. Now we can build another checkout. Really? Queue size 10. We've got to hire 2 more cashiers. That's a lot of money. It's a lot of money. There it is. Turn a daily profit over $5,000. And I collected $20,000 from that. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. Is it happening again? Okay, no. It's not the corona. Last episode we had a virus outbreak. Everyone was going crazy. It looks like our profits haven't gone unnoticed. Our workers have unionized. What? Huh? Unionized? Expected union reps to regularly push for a minimum salary raise. Why? What? Why? Why? Oh, because I'm making money and you guys want more? Uh-huh. Bet. How much more money do they? Oh, they're working. Ew. Hold on. Wait, not you guys. Let's look at the grocery store. How much are they getting paid? This person's getting paid. They're all different. Oh, well, yeah, they're all different because this cashier is really good as opposed to Russell, who just started. So that's why he gets paid $11. Erica just started. That's why she gets paid $10. I hope I don't hear from the union because I'm not about to give them any more money than what I've been giving them already. They're not getting more money. It's not happening. I can tell you that right now. Nope. Nope. They're gonna have to fight me. So in 22 hours, I'm going to switch. We got 9 shelves. These 9 shelves right here will all be candy. We've got bread. Yeah, we've got canned foods and sauces, breakfast cereal, coffee and tea. Candy's up here. Let's switch this one to let's switch it to rice and pasta. Okay, so yeah, are there any more candies? No. So these 9 shelves down here will be for candy. In the next 18 hours, why are people still getting pissy? Okay, we've had 22 occurrences, so 22 people, I believe, have left. We have 6 cashiers. This is it. I can't even talk. We have 6 cashiers. 60 different people are coming up in line, and we're 22 short. Meaning I can still put in like two more cashiers to then... Oh my god, I'm gonna have to add in two more cashiers. We're gonna have to add in two more cashiers. I'm not even joking. So what I'll do is I'll expand this back area right here, getting closer to the end of the road, and I'm gonna put two, three more cashiers up there. That's the best thing that I can do. We are 64 people behind. So I think that's the mechanic. I think that if the line's full, they leave. They don't wait or anything. The moment that the line's full, 10 people, if they're the 11th and there's no space, obviously, they leave. It's gone. That's it. I'm just waiting for the bar to be completed. Are they unionizing? Look, it popped up again. 80 people. We had 80 people that left. Union reps will vote on a minimum salary raise to $11 an hour in 20 days. What? Everyone's getting paid $11. Lobbying cost is $125,000. Is that for me? They're gonna charge me $125,000? I'm losing my voice. I'm literally losing my voice. Hold on. I think I need to drink some tea. $125,000? Nah, they're joking, right? So I have to pay everyone $11 an hour?